What's up, everybody? My name is Alex Chung, and today we are talking about the new features on the Zhiying Crane 2. Zhiying recently came out with a new firmware upgrade to the Crane 2. This new update features two new shooting modes, a full range POV and the Vortex mode, as well as introducing compatibility with the Nikon Z6 and Z7 mirrorless cameras. It's an incredible update to an already 2-year-old gimbal that breathes new life into it, and it's really nice to see that Zhiying is constantly trying to give the best possible experience for these gimbals. Now, just as a side note, the version that I'm installing today is version number 1.77, which includes a little bit of minor fixes, but has all of the features from 1.76. So let's take a look at what these two new features are, but before we can do that, we have to upgrade our firmware. You're gonna need two things in order to upgrade your gimbal, and the first one is the Zhiying Gimbal Tools program that you can download off of their official site, and then the second one is the firmware update file itself. And you can find both of these things on their official website, which I will leave a link to down below. And after you've downloaded the firmware and the gimbal tools program, go ahead and fire up the program and connect your Crane 2 to your computer via the micro USB that it's provided in the case. Now in the program, we're gonna browse to the firmware update file. And once you load that in, go ahead and click the upgrade button. And after a few minutes, the gimbal is updated and you're ready to use it. All right, so now that you have your Crane 2 fully updated, let's take a look at the first feature, which is the full range POV mode. Before 1.76, you could only tilt the gimbal 45 degrees to the left or the right in POV mode. If you tried to go further than 45 degrees, the gimbal would give out and the arms would stop balancing. This wasn't just a balancing issue, there wasn't anything that you could do to calibrate it or anything like that. This was only because the motors weren't programmed to do it. But now, thanks to a few lines of code, you're now able to fully rotate the gimbal 360 degrees on all three axes. And according to Zhiying, this allows the gimbal to perform similar to what a traditional Steadicam would do. So next we have the Vortex mode. Now this mode is already introduced in the Crane 3 and a bunch of other gimbals that have a different name for it. They all mean and do the same thing, which is rotating the camera 360 degrees on a single axis. Before 1.76, this wasn't even an option in the shooting modes. You only had pan follow, follow, lock, and POV mode. But now after 1.76, you can switch to Vortex mode and begin shooting barrel rolls and spinning shots just like the Crane 3 and other gimbals. Although I probably won't be using this mode very often, it's nice to see that Zhiying is keeping Crane 2 users up to date and competitive with the other gimbals. And last but not least, the Crane 2 now supports the Nikon Z6 and Z7 mirrorless cameras. With the new update, you're now able to control the aperture, shutter speed, ISO, and the start and stop recording on the newest Nikon cameras. And this gives Nikon shooters one more option when they're trying to look for a compatible gimbal that supports their cameras. And since this is already a couple years old, it's definitely a more affordable option. I'll leave a link down below for you guys to check it out. So that's it, guys. A quick little video going over some of the new updates to the Crane 2. It's always nice when companies do these sorts of updates for their older products just so that they can give us the best experience possible. If you guys have any other questions on the new firmware update, the Crane 2 in general, leave a comment down below and I'll answer them. And if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Make sure to subscribe. Hit the bell to get notified of every video that I post. My name is Alex Chung and I'll see you later. Bye.